Welcome to this video on the NCDOT migration from SharePoint 2010 to SharePoint 2013. The migration to SharePoint 2013 will affect your work with the NCDOT websites, so this video focuses on the features that are brand new in SharePoint 2013 to help you get up to speed quickly. SharePoint 2013 Search offers a preview function, so you do not have to open a file to get an idea of its contents. We'll use some search results from inside NCDOT as our example. Search for Set Alert to find files that contain both of those words. The standard results page contains an icon, name, matching text in context, URL, and other metadata. If you hover over a result, you'll see a pop-up that contains additional information on the contents of the file, as well as options to work with the file. Depending upon your permissions, you can view the library that contains the file, or even open the file for editing. In SharePoint 2013 libraries, you can also preview file information. We'll use Connect NCDOT as our example. Here's a 2013 library that contains SharePoint help files. Click the ellipsis next to the file name. You'll see some of the file properties and options. Here, the preview includes a modified date, the URL for the file, and basic file operations such as edit. Those operations will vary with your permission level. If you need further information or options for that file, click the second ellipsis for additional actions. SharePoint 2013 has added a search function to individual libraries. We'll use a Connect NCDOT library. The search box is located at the top of the library. Now let's enter the query text "set alert" in quotation marks to find matches for that exact phrase. Then click the magnifying glass to launch the search. The title and content of each file in the library are examined and matches are returned. Advantages of this library search are twofold. The narrow focus on only one library makes it very quick, and the results are displayed within the library itself, not on a separate results page. In SharePoint 2013, you can now drag and drop multiple files from your computer directly into a SharePoint library. You will find this a much faster approach than opening Windows Explorer within SharePoint. We'll use a library on inside NCDOT as our example. Note the Drag Files Here area. On your computer, browse to the files you want to upload. Shift and click to select several contiguous files. Press and hold the left mouse button and drag the files to the Drop Here area in the SharePoint library. Release the mouse button to copy the files. In the SharePoint library, new files are identified with a green star. In this particular library, Checkout Check-In is on, so the files have a status of checked out until you check them in. Any required properties must be completed before you are allowed to check in the files. The Quick Edit feature in SharePoint 2013 lets you work with multiple items or files at the same time. You'll find Quick Edit to be a feature that really helps your efficiency. We'll use a list in inside NCDOT as our example. Open Quick Edit by going to the ribbon, clicking the List tab, and clicking Quick Edit. The display changes to a spreadsheet-style format. To edit an item, simply click the property you wish to change. It might be a single line of text or a choice. However it was defined in SharePoint is how it is presented in Quick Edit. To add an item, scroll to the bottom of the page where there is an empty row. Add the properties for your new item. Once entry is complete, another empty row appears so you can add another item. Here's a nice shortcut to copy and paste content. Highlight the content that you want to copy, then grab the small bar in the lower right. In this example, we'll drag it down to copy the entire row, then change two of the values. Once your changes are complete, all you do is click Stop Editing This List to save them. This example of Quick Edit has used a list. In a library, you can edit the properties of files just as you would edit properties in a list, but you cannot use Quick Edit to upload or create files. In SharePoint 2013, you can set an alert on a search. This means that the search query is saved and periodically rerun. If new results are available, you'll receive an alert. To set an alert, run a search query, then scroll to the bottom of the first results page. Click the Alert Me option and define the characteristics of the alert as you would any other alert. In this video, we've shared the key new features in SharePoint 2013. We encourage you to check out our other videos and to contact the PC Training Group for information on SharePoint 2013 classes. Thanks for watching.